I'm Wilfred Brimley, and I'd like to talk to you for a few minutes about diabetes. Actually, about diabetes and how it's affected me in my life.
Hey everybody, Kevin from the Other Dimension here. Today is a red letter day. For once, I was approached by one of the bands that said the other way around. Mr. Kenneth Marshall Myers of the band of the punk band Chump approached me online to possibly video record a set of his at Beerland Texas, and there were two other bands playing with him, Favor and the Blowies. Now, if you like the Dickies, you're gonna love the Blowies, because you know the Blowies sort of complement the Dickies. I could use a Blowie myself. Anyways, as we started to get permission for this, more and more bands started jumping on. We had Aint Nothins, who are also new on the scene. We have Dr. Scientist. I've only listened to a sample of what these bands have done, but I haven't really heard their whole set, so we're gonna listen and give them a chance to wow us for the first time, at least for me. And if we really like what they do, if it's a really good movie, I'm gonna send it out to everybody on LinkedIn that I can find in the music industry. And luckily for us, Brenda Dickerson has agreed to show up for this. And it's also a turning point in Brenda Dickerson's career. Brenda, after working for 20 or so years for the governor's mansion as a landscaper, is retiring soon and making the full jump into television. So that's going to be something exciting to talk about. So, let's watch.
It ain't suicide, it's constantly romanticized, and it's fucking disgusting! It's suicide, romanticized, it's suicide, romanticized. Don't you dare try it, empathize with me. I just wanna die, take me from my slavery. I'm gonna blow up, I'm gonna fucking explode. It's not beautiful, it's fucking pitiful. Did it suicide, romanticize. Did it suicide, romanticize. Did it suicide, romanticize. Gonna change your mind, gonna warp your brain. Snap yourself out of your self-destructive game. Oh, you say you hate it, you're infatuated. Wanna die, wanna die, wanna lie, wanna lie. Get into a side or make a side.
So we're here at Beerland, Texas, a little early today, but Brenda Dickerson's on her way, and once she gets here, the fun can begin.
Brenda, so good to see you again. It's been so long.
It's been a long time.
How long do you think it's been since Brenda Fest?
I lost track of everybody when my phone died.
Oh, really?
And Facebook blocked me.
I think it's been almost...
My phone numbers and my Facebook contacts.
I think it's been almost a year since our last movie. It's our first film of 2019. Yeah, we're here for some new bands tonight. Let me get you over here. Get you over there by this two times. So, normally Brenda knows the band, but tonight none of us know the bands. One of the bands, Chump, took the time to watch my film work, and they were the ones who approached me, so that's kind of cool to be approached by someone for the first time. So.
I love seeing new bands, though. Sometimes they turn out to be your favorites.
Yeah, and some of these bands appear to be very young, too. So, tell me, what have you been doing these past months? I know your retirement is coming up. How long did you work for the governor's pastor?
27 years. But it all ends in 11 days.
Wow. It is a red letter day, isn't it?
It is. So I'm ready to get the hell out of there.
I give you full credit. This is a getup that I haven't seen before.
And then I should be moved out to the scare grounds here another month or so after that.
So I noticed you've been doing some stuff with Horror Web. You want to talk about that?
Yeah, we've been doing, they've given me my own new show, Brenda's Bloody Bedtime Stories. I'll be hosting four movies, kind of like what Elvira used to do, except all the movies I show were going to be old black and white horror movies. None of the new stuff.
Of course, public domain stuff.
First episode was Nosferatu. We actually started with a silent movie. And you know, I get to give a little background on it. Some of the history of how it was made and the trouble they had. Like the fact that Nosferatu was not supposed to have been released to begin with, but they managed to get it out there anyway.
Yeah, well,
then they're letting me spank a few people.
Dr. Caligari. Are you getting to spank people on the show?
Yes.
Yeah.
We will be spanking people. And in fact, not my show, but the other show that Horror Web does, I'm just one of the cast members as Brenda. And I'm traveling the galaxy with a giant dildo and a riding crop. And we're here on Earth to warn y'all of the apocalypse, but you Earthlings aren't the brightest creatures.
Cool. Let me take a step back here. I want to show your full getup. Yeah, one bad motherfucker. Yeah, take a good look.
Yeah.
Okay, keep going.
And I said, I'm with the Orlok and then my friend Scara of Horror Web, who's the one that does my makeup. And the cool part on that show is it's being made into a comic book that's going to follow along with the movies. And I can show you the picture later or send it to you of what Brenda's going to look like animated. We just got that about a week ago. A guy in New Orleans is doing the drawings for us. And so we all got to see what we look like in a cartoon. And, you know, I'm swinging the riding. I got the riding crop and the dildo in the picture.
Well, I also put you in a couple of Bad Goddess episodes. It wasn't a cartoon, but you were in with cartoons, technically.
It'll be a lot of fun, man. And we've kind of put all that on the back burner temporarily. We're trying to get this thing started with getting the cabin set up and getting moved, you know, out here south of town, where we can.
Okay, so your studio is outside the city limits?
Yeah. We're out towards Buda on about 15 acres. And it's gonna take a year or two to get almost two to get the whole thing done. But pretty quickly, we're trying to get the dungeon built and the spaceship and the fire-breathing dragon, all the fun stuff.
So tell me, did you get to go to Frightmare this year?
Yes, I did.
You did? You know Kevin Bensick from the Solid Ravencraft's Vault of Horror videos? Kevin and Jasmine offered to let me shack up with them for Frightmare next year, and they'll get me in for free if I just man a booth for a couple of hours. That sounds cool. Now, if I could just find a way to swing that into a documentary.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun up there. That was my ninth one in a row, 8 or 9 years
it's like
in a row.
Disneyland for horror addicts.
You know, and it's some of the prices have gotten a little higher, better. The thing is, when you've been that many times, I have people there that are like family that are from other states. They're not from around here. And that's the only time we see each other. Once a year, we're all at Frightmare, getting decked out and taking pictures, hanging out in the club till all hours of the night.
I saw Sarah Webb taking a picture with the demon from Death Note. So what were your guest celebrities that you got to be with?
As far as the celebrities, the only one I paid for was Jenna Jameson, because she's just so sexy. I thought we made a pretty cute couple, actually.
Was she a porn star or something?
Yeah. But she's also, she worked with Robert Englund. They did a movie called Zombie Strippers.
Wow.
That was pretty cool. It was a strip club that was being taken over by zombies. And it's a pretty fun movie. And she was real sweet. That's what I found about a lot of the people in the horror industry. They're not anything evil about them when you meet them in person. Elvira, everybody I've ever met up there, just the sweetest they could be.
Yeah, well, they got to do something in their spare time, right?
Yeah.
Elvira, that's cool to see Elvira still around. I can't even remember
she was
watching
sweet.
Your show, it's been so long. When's the last time you saw something with Elvira?
Probably 6 months or so. I watched one of her. I've got her like a whole set of DVDs that she autographed for me when I met her 3 or 4 years ago. It's like 26 episodes of her show.
Doesn't Joe Ball at Briggs have a show too?
Yeah, same type of thing. And now Brenda, who would figure?
Well, it makes sense. You're in all these documentaries, you're on Zombie Life TV. The next progressive step is to get your own TV show or web show, whichever. Baby steps at a time. And like I said, I sent all our movies to a talent scout that works for Row Records, which is a part of Sony Pictures. There's another guy online that I'll send a video to that has like 4 platinum records, if you understand. So,
that's been a fun ride.
For a fifth one. And that's the point of these videos tonight. I'm going to give these unknown bands a chance to shine in a movie.
You know, I was at an auto parts store the other day, and somebody kept saying they knew me from somewhere. And I told them probably from, like, down here at Elysium or some of the places I hang out at. And then, but as I turned to walk away from them, they saw the tattoo. And I'm like, no, I know where I remember where I know you from. You were on Zombie Life TV.
Yeah, that amazes me whenever I meet somebody that actually watches public access, because God knows when we were on that show, none of us did, you know. Yeah. Now I watch it on DVD. I burned it to DVD afterwards, you know. So.
Yeah, I watched a few of the episodes, you know, afterwards, just online.
I created a DVD set called The Best of Zombie Life TV.
But that, I wasn't expecting that when they said they knew me from somewhere. And when they saw the tattoo, they knew right away. They said, oh no, you're Brenda. Because I was working on my car. I was greasy
and
not dressed
up. Okay, we gotta
wrap this up
because I think the music's starting.
Back to the car. What you got here? There you go.
Let's look at this in the light.
Wow. There's a four-way city, everything on the bag. Everything you need to know about Brenda.
Cool.
That we're afraid to ask.
Hey everybody, let's put Brenda.
See if I can find my
beer. I noticed that you often say that you get booked for parties and such.
Yeah. I've been invited to a lot of stuff lately. We get starting to get a lot of free entry into clubs. The ones that I hang out at the most. Or because bands are playing there that are friends of mine. And, I'm going to get to be in a couple of more rock videos coming up. And also, for everyone to put on their calendar, September 21st will be the third annual Brenda Fest. I got a couple of cool bands lined up. And I'm talking to a couple of others. And again, we'll have drag queens, Alien Burlesque. I'm hoping to get the girls from Zombie Peep Show with all the fancy boots. I'm going to try to get them to come out. They're part of our team now, too.
I assume this is a Texas Mist again? I assume this is a Texas Mist again?
Yeah. Got to be there at least this year, maybe one more. Eventually, we want to have it out at Bat City. There's no way we'll have it anywhere near enough ready by September. But maybe by next year. Jim was real agreeable. He enjoyed last year and told us we could have it there as many times as we wanted.
Well, that's nice.
And
nice
me and Alyssa are working on another song to get up and misbehave in front of everybody. Give us a chance to put on some crazy costumes and misbehave in front of our friends.
Yeah, watching you do burlesque is always fun.
Yeah, one of the bands I'm gonna go see again, the band called Venus and then TRA. They're gonna open in a couple of weeks for, I'm gonna get to see Alice Cooper's daughter. She has her own band now.
Cool.
Now, I've seen her perform with Alice as part of the stage show, but it'll be my first time to see her on her own. She's pretty sexy and seemed to have a good stage show. I think she borrowed part of her dad's band. I guess while he's taking a break, she's touring and using some of the same musicians.
I need to check my time here.
Scientists. Let's have some fun. What's up, everybody? Hey, yeah. We are Dr. Scientist. It's a pleasure to be here. Yeah. Yeah, this next song is called Daggers. We'll be right back.
Alright, we're about to play a song. We just put out an EP a few weeks ago called All the Right Things EP. And this next song is called So Many Words, and it's on that EP. If you like it, check it out on the Spotify's and the Apples and the iTunes and the Oranges and the Pears. Whatever you want, bro. We are Dr. Scientist. We got a few more tunes for y'all.
What were those last two?
What?
What were those last two streaming sites?
Oh, the Oranges and the Pears?
Yeah, those.
Yeah. And the Orchid, Orchard, and the Portrait, and the Smorkard. I don't know, man. I don't make up these names. People just like fruits and shit. What do you want from me?
A veggie would be nice.
Yeah, man. Spotify, broccoli fire. Yeah, oh, my monitor. Oh, there we go.
Veggie, pineapple, carrot.
Special thanks to Beerland, all the bands, Blowies, Aint Nothins, Favor, Chump. Am I missing any? That's four, right? It's a miracle I can remember that much. You guys rule. I'm excited to see all your sets. I'm gonna stick around. That song was called So Many Words, also known as Ooh.
Shut up, I think it's funny.
Nothing better than when only one member in your band thinks you're funny and no one else does. Alright, we got a few more for y'all. So the next one's a fun one, it's called Maybe. Maybe we'll do it good. This song because I get the solo for 20 minutes.
Mr. Scientist.
Man, they sounded good. I'll be definitely checking everyone out tonight. See if I want to invite anyone to our show in September.
Yeah, that guy kind of had me worried there for a second. He said he was going to do 20 minutes of solos.
Yeah. It had a good sound, but I don't want to see. What do we got? Four other bands still?
Yep. Yeah. Cool. Oh, let's get to
I'll
that.
I'll see. I don't know about. I think Texas Mitch lets underage people play too. But I can always find out.
Okay, well.
I know the Dirty Dog. I know a lot of clubs do that. It's always the same thing. You see the big X on the back of the hand. That says they can't drink.
Hi, we're here with Dr. Scientist, so please introduce yourselves.
Oh, hi, my name's Trevor.
Hi.
I'm Patrick.
And you?
Tristan. I thought it was a picture.
Yeah, that's it.
Usual questions. How did you and your band members first meet?
We first met, let's see. Actually, this music school I work at, Tristan's wife works at that music school as well. We had a birthday party for the owner, and we just jammed on a Beatles song before. And so I met him just out of happenstance. And then I was looking for a bassist, and our good friend Andy said, hey, call this guy, Patrick. He rules. And I always trust what Andy says, so
by rules, he means is available.
Yeah, he's that. He
has
available.
Time.
That's how we met.
He's willing
yeah.
to learn.
Let's just hold each other.
Everybody's just meeting each other. Yeah. Now, what got you interested in this kind of music, your kind of music? Influences.
Oh man, I listened to a lot of emo punk, pop punk stuff growing up, and I feel like, I don't want to speak for these guys, but I feel like I also got into a lot of other styles of music as I got older, so I was able to incorporate that into the whole pop punk thing. I think that's why these guys like it, because it's not just...
We're all kind of kids of the early 2000s.
Yeah, it's not too emo, it's not too pop punk.
Whether you were into it or not,
it's a part of yours.
It, yeah, just by osmosis.
Yeah.
It gets in there. I
wasn't. We all love it secretly.
I never was. I was never into it.
Yeah.
Save for maybe Coheed.
Yeah.
But playing with Trevor, his songs lend themselves to a lot of texture. And I love playing that kind of bass with like different levels of distortion.
Yeah.
And the octave and the wah. It's a lot of fun.
A lot of sounds.
Yeah.
So, what are you currently working on at the moment?
So, we just put out an EP.
A documentary.
I am currently demoing out some new songs. So, there's going to be a full length in the future. Right now, we're just focusing on playing lots of shows and pushing the EP we just came out with. But there will be a full length definitely in the future.
Okay, so how has your music evolved since you first started playing?
Well,
it's gotten better.
Yeah, hopefully.
Or worse.
I think,
depends on how you ask.
I think that it has definitely, it started out with kind of more modest punk rock roots, but over time I've kind of crafted my songwriting to try to incorporate different elements a little more while still having a similar sound, a cohesive sound. So it's just including more variety of genre, but it's still cohesive.
Dude, you've got grunge progressions, you've got pop punk, attitudes, it's
a little bit of soul,
baby.
You got some jazz goddamn chords.
You got some jazz chords. We're just doing it all, baby. We're trying to do it all.
You're an educated man playing music.
Where do you see this going in the future?
Going good.
Probably sleeping on the side of the road eventually. No, I don't know.
No, that's my future.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
okay.
He'll be right next to you. It's gonna be a little homeless unit.
Well,
you're in this movie.
We might expand and add another member. We're definitely thinking about it. Maybe her. She seems nice. What's your name?
Do you play keys?
Do you play keys and or guitar? I don't know what that means. Alright. Yeah, we're probably gonna expand the sound. Just not sure when. But right now we're just focusing on Right now we're focusing on really just perfecting the sound we have as a trio. And once we feel like it's really getting to the point where we want to move outside that, we'll probably add another member.
Okay, well thank you.
Thank you.
This one's called 52 Minutes to Make It to the Border, and it's a brand new one. Of originals that just kind of flow into one another. Got Alright, so in this band, we got Lo Gomez on the bass. On drums, we got our freaking boy, Evan Campbell. And I'm Jimmy, and I just play guitar and sing. Thank you.
the band.
How did you like Favor?
They kicked ass off.
Man, I gotta tell you, that was really cool because, you know, you see these older rock stars playing and you're like, where did they start come from? Where did they get their start? It's like it's like kids, like teenagers like that, that are practicing their rock and taking it seriously to grow up to be the rock stars, man.
Yeah, they were rocking it for someone that young. Good stage presence, good guitar playing, the whole bit. The kid was drumming his ass off.
So tell me, you said you were going to a Christine concert tomorrow.
That's the plan. Like I say, I got shows Friday and Saturday. That's why I'm looking forward to being retired, where I don't have to get up every morning.
It's kind of hard. You can just go hang out and party all the time?
Yeah, and I can just keep vampire hours, especially in the summer. That hot part of the day, I'm going to lay in front of the air conditioner and take a nap.
Well, who knows? If I can get my plans in this game to work, maybe we'll get more band offers to shoot more of these, you know? You never know.
Yeah. Like I say, the new part-time job, they don't care what hours I work. I work whatever hours are the most weather convenient. I ain't going out in the cold, and I ain't going out in the heat.
More to come. Stay tuned.
We're here with the band Favor. So, Favor, please introduce yourselves.
I'm Lo. I play bass in Favor.
And Neece?
I'm Jimmy Mercado. I play drums and... I mean, not drums. I play guitar and sing.
Wow, so y'all look new to this. It's good to see some new blood in this. So, tell me, how did you and your band members first meet?
I first met Jimmy in a program called Band-Aid School of Music. We were put in the same group, and we later on regrouped to be in Favor.
I met Lo through Band-Aid, and I met Evan through this thing called Longhorn Music Camp. It's like this band camp, but we met there, and we've just known each other since.
This intrigues me. So underage people can get in to play shows at live music venues that serve alcohol too.
Yeah.
That's I never knew that. I never knew that. So yeah. That's really cool to know.
It's on y'all here.
Yeah. Yeah. So, what got you interested in this kind of music? Who are your influences?
We're influenced by bands like The Garden, King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard.
Pretty much those two, and we try to make our own sound out of all that stuff, because like you shouldn't try to like create what's already made. You should try to like make something new that will intrigue people.
Cool. So what are you currently working on at the moment?
We're working on putting together our album, final product of our album.
Do you have a title for that album? A work in progress.
It's pretty much a work in progress, but we have all the songs done, but we just basically got to start recording.
I know all about work in progress. I make these little video comic cartoons, and I have one that's just been dragged out for nearly a year called Certain Natural Pimp Decks. Maybe I'll get it finished this year, hopefully.
Nice.
So, you're a band member?
Yep.
Yeah.
I already asked you what you were working on the moment. How has your music evolved since you first started playing?
Well, when we first started playing, it was just me and Evan, and we wrote a lot of like short punk, like really fast punk songs, but ever since we got Lo, we've been just evolving and just growing so much.
Yeah, but we try to build upon what we've already done and make it a little more unique and interesting as we progress.
Okay, so where do you see this going in the future?
We've gone through a lot of phases, and I think we're just gonna keep like building on this last one. We found kind of our own sound now, and so I think we're just going to keep like playing more shows, recording music, just having fun.
Okay. That's all the questions I got. Do y'all have anything else you'd like to say?
Check out our Instagram, and hopefully we'll have music out soon.
Okay, I'll be sure to list that in the end credits for y'all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I just got to see my friend, Tiger Sex is the name of their band. They're out of Cincinnati. I've been friends with them 3 or 4 years, I guess. But I love that she actually has tiger stripes tattooed on her ass. And this time she actually has them on her thigh. She's extending them on down her leg. But
but I told her I would match her when she got here, and I had a friend of mine here in town that does airbrushing, and she actually used airbrush paint because she said it would stay longer, but she used watercolor brushes, and she put tiger stripes over my entire butt cheeks. I wore a thong to the concert so everyone could see that I had tiger stripes, and me and Kelly Chelston, that's her name, we took the pictures together. I had tiger stripes up and down my arms and all over my face. She did a complete tiger look on me. She gave me some good ideas for some other things I want to do. Now that I know someone that can, she don't care where she puts makeup. She put it on me anywhere I asked her to. We're gonna have some fun with that.
Two people, great. Me and Jimmy. All right. Oh, three people, all right. Three people in the world in this venue have cell phones. That's good to know. I guess we're all populating Instagram. And it's just our various masks that we see in the selfies. I have a collection of selfies.
Really?
Just of my own. My phone categorizes it for me. It's crazy.
How many are there?
I don't know, man.
Come on and show my ego, you're the beast.
How y'all feeling out there? Hey, y'all, give it up for Dr. Scientist in favor. So I don't know if you guys follow the news at all, but you don't? Well, lucky you. We got a guy in the presidency with tiny hands. Tiny song for a tiny man. Hey, you guys, we are the Blowies, by the way. Yeah, somebody said what I just said. So, in case you didn't know me, now you do. Thank you. See how I changed the word no, put an E on the end to rhyme it with our name. Clever. Cheers. Thank you. I needed that. Oh, so this next song is from the point of view of a gun-toting motherfucker.
Just drink beer and say yes.
say yes. Just drink beer and say yes.
Say yes.
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 So when I get your bass, do I also get the beer? Yeah?
Yes!
Well, I kinda want my beer. You could have mine if I could have yours. Or we could do a beer swap as well as a bass guitar swap. You know how they have that wife swap TV show? They should have a beer swap TV show.
Alright.
Once again, we are the Blowies. Thank you guys for being here. We got some things for sale back there if y'all are interested. And an email list.
Yeah, we actually made some shirts recently. This guy's rocking one over here. Hey, y'all, give it up for Sam Thompson on the guitar.
Yeah, I haven't played guitar yet, though.
Oh, yeah.
Hasn't played guitar.
Give it up for Tucker on bass.
Thank you. Woo! I haven't played bass.
Beer swapper.
That's exactly right. So, he's rocking our Blowies tee, which we got in the back, and we desperately need to sell.
Handmade.
Because we invested everything that we ever earned in life into those t-shirts. So it's on you guys now to make sure we get our next meal. I'm ranting, so he's shutting me up.
Tucker.
Cool. So, how did you and your band members first meet?
The astral plane.
The astral plane?
Yeah.
Wow, you had an out-of-body experience?
Absolutely. Yeah, it was pretty wild.
Oh my god, how did you get to that point?
Orgasm.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Wow, nice. So what got you interested in this kind of music, your kind of music? Who were your influences?
Well, kind of always been interested in this kind of music. We like bands like the Clash and the Sex Pistols. Sex Pistols, one of my favorites. On Her Majesty's Secret Service, great album, great album.
Coincidentally, I watched Sid and Nancy building up to this film with Gerald.
Oh, yeah. Cool, cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So fucking classic rock, dude.
Yeah.
Classic punk.
Yeah. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay, so what are you currently working on right now, at the moment?
I'm working on myself. I've been reading a lot of, self-help books, like, I think Oprah's got one out right now that I want to check out. I've got a jalapeno garden I've been working on.
You
gotta keep it hot. I'm retired.
You got yours at the beginning of the movie. Okay.
I'm gonna have to work 11 more days and I'm fucking through.
How has your music
evolved
since you first started playing?
What's the question?
How has your music evolved since you first started playing?
Well, evolution is a really slow process. It takes thousands of years.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, I'd say we're still like single-celled animals in the ocean.
Okay. No, where do you see this going in the future?
I don't really think about it, to be honest.
You don't?
We kind of do our own thing, you know? We kind of do it day by day. We do it because we want to do it.
Cool.
Yeah.
Okay, the Blowies, everybody.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. You were wondering what kind of shirt I was wearing. Here it is. The most evil fucking shirt I can think of. Necromantic. And I'm not going to lie. I rent this movie just so I would look like I didn't know what I was talking about. And a few minutes, and like maybe 10 to 30 minutes of the movie, I had to shut it off. It was just that fucked up and sick. Mm-hmm. I just couldn't sleep with that in my head. I had to put on Aquaman to get it out. You know, so there you go. So, where do I get these wonderful shirts? It's Secret October. And who taught me to shut it? Brenda Dickerson. And cut.
We are the Aint Nothins. And, you ready?
No.
Here we go. Yeah. we're the Aint Nothins. We got Lance, first time playing with us. He's new, our regular bassist had a baby. And Ian on the drums. And I'm Dave. This song is called This Time. Yeah. Yeah, the Blitzkrieg Bop? Yeah, I don't think I get the kind credit in Blitzkrieg Bop. Almost.
We'll be right back.
we're here with the band Aint Nothins. And so, tell me your names, guys.
Well, I'm Ian.
I'm Dave.
Okay, so tell me, how did you and your band members meet? How did you two meet?
Actually, our wives work together, and they thought we should hang out and play music. So they kind of set us up. We started jamming in Dave's garage, and then we found a bassist on Craigslist, and now we're a real band.
Cool. Well, what got you interested in this kind of music? Your kind of music? Who were your influences?
Yeah.
I mean, a lot of stuff is like Stiff Little Fingers or TSOL or Agnostic Front, sort of classic hardcore, sort of all the influences we have.
Yeah. Yeah. Funny, you know, like I like punk, kind of more of a sludge and stoner rock guy. So I'm playing punk with them. I'm playing it a little slower beat though, trying to get more of like a washy stoner metal sound.
Cool. So tell me, what are you currently working on at the moment?
Well, we got 6 songs in the can on an EP. It's on Bandcamp, and we've been writing some new ones and playing out.
Okay, so you're just starting out. This question is like, how has your music evolved since you first started playing? But I know you're just starting out, so... I don't know. Do you want to fake the question?
You know what? The way our music evolves as we write it, is we write a riff, and just every practice it gets faster and faster until we like it. And that's kind of the evolution of any and every song we've got, right?
Yeah, it's pretty organic.
Cool. So, where do you see this going in the future? Is this a hobby, or do you see a full career out of it?
Whether or not it's a full career, we're trying to play around town and just make a name for ourselves here, at least as a punk band in Austin.
I think we're pretty realistic about the possibilities, but yeah, I think big for us is like free drinks at the bar.
Okay. Thank you very much. Aint Nothins, everybody.
Thank you.
Coming up next, folks, we're going to see if we saved the best for last. Watch out for Chump.
You control your life, power brings you your eyes. Watching you hold her hand, she's a young artist. Don't forget, she'll remember when you're angry. Don't forget, she'll remember when you're angry. We'll be right back.
of too slow. I'm feeling like that's kind of too slow. Off our first EP. Well, it doesn't really matter. We're trying to just push as much sweat out of my body right now as I can. And so we've got one more song. It's about scraping your head against the wall because you really feel good. Four clicks.
Time!
I'd hurt myself for sure.
I don't know. I think CD Plus had sort of scraper at this point, you know?
I guess I can get hurt in
this.
I'm sure I can get hurt in platform boots, though, too.
Well, wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we end the end of the night, we are with the band Chump. CD Flaus and who are the other two? You two.
I'm Harrison.
Okay. So tell me, how did you and your band members first meet?
I met them at a show. I saw them playing with their old guitarist. We hung out, me and CD hung out one time, and I played guitar and we started practicing together, and I became the new guitarist.
Yeah, it was all good stuff. It was like just very quick at how everything happened, I guess. Like,
what about you?
I met CD through work.
Yeah, you fucked up my sandwich.
Yeah.
I came into Thundercloud and I said, all right, I want a Nada, because whatever. And then he just, like, I watched him put it in the microwave. He just never took it out, but that's okay. Like, and then I got the sandwich and I was like, fuck, man. And, yeah.
Okay, man shot. So, what got you interested in this kind of music, your kind of music? Who were your influences?
Oh, Black Flag, big time. Me and Dirt are really into Minutemen, too. I'm really into The Germs. Really just classic punk, I guess.
Yeah, and I got a lot of my music influence. I started listening to Blink-182, which is kind of like yuck, but then I got more into political things, like, maybe not so much political, but like Bad Religion was very cool for me, like the skate punk, the really fast 1-2. I was like, damn, like that makes me fuck. I want to get off on that. So I got Black Flag and, you know, all that stuff. So
and like the classic for the drummer would be Neil Peart, but then I would say who gave me a lot of my inspiration would be Simon Phillips from Judas Priest. But I really think the Les Binks is underrated. And then Bill Stevenson, he really got me cornered into where I wanted to go.
That looked amazing, by the way.
Thanks, man.
What are you currently working on at the moment?
Right now we're gearing up for we're going on this crazy 2-month tour, so we're just doing these really grueling good 8-hour practices, a lot of sweat. And besides that, we're going to be working on this new album, the Wife Beating Child Haters EP, or album, I don't know, it's got a lot of songs on it, but it's not quite long enough. But the tour, we're going to be hitting the whole West Coast, going there all the way up to Portland, Oregon, carving our way back down. We've got two shows in Houston. Then August 2nd, after we finish wrapping up the live album, we're gonna hit our way back to the Midwest, go to Chicago, come back down, and then that'll be it. That's our summer plan. Big summer run.
Okay, so how has your music evolved since you first started playing?
It's definitely gotten a lot faster. There's some old recordings I was playing. It's real slow, really couldn't do it very well, but you know, what would you say? Say there's a lot more anger.
Hot seat quiz. No, Eddie used to have this thing called a hot seat quiz on our show, and instead of a discussion, there you go. Do you believe in Bigfoot? Do you believe in aliens? Do you believe in mass government conspiracies? Yeah. And finally, we like sat and told him about it. So he did what he did was he sat down and he had an honest to God 1-hour long discussion about Bigfoot that was actually a serious discussion. And we were like completely wowed that you did that. So God bless you, Eddie. I'll never forget it. Now, where do you see this going in the future? What are your plans?
My plans are stay off drugs, definitely not load up. You know, if you want to load up, go for it. I'm too busy trying to sweat. I just really fucking like sweating, so that's where all the seizuring and freaking out and getting angry comes from. Harrison, I mean, I see it going a lot forward with Harrison. I mean, our old guitar player, cool guy, but I'm really stoked to have him because we've got we've been very progressive now. Now we actually are able to do the practices and really run through the shit, you know?
Yeah, just make the best music we can for as long as we can.
Yeah, definitely.
What about you?
Less work, more play.
Less work, more play.
Amen.
Well, thank you guys. Thank all three of you. You know, if it wasn't for CD Flaus just reaching out to me, this movie wouldn't exist. So thank you. If it wasn't for Brenda, I would not have an actor in my movies. Thank you, Brenda.
Thank you, everybody, for watching. Have a good night.
Woo! There's a lot of stuff I could ramble on about, but I need a prompt. It's like a writing prompt in school. You know how they used to give you us writing prompts?
Yeah.
Remember that? It's like they give you
it would be like talk like, about
yeah this and that, and then you have to make a story out of it.
Yeah. What's a good writing prompt? It's like tell us about a time where. You won something, but you didn't feel too good about it.
Right. So it has you focus on the moral dilemma, perhaps. Maybe unjustifiably gaining something or something else you should have.
You know what? I got a better topic.
Okay. I hope so. Because that was kind of lame. Nobody wants to hear me talk about morals.
So I've been doing a lot of research on the flat earth theory.
Alright,
what do you got, Tucker, on the flat earth?
Right, yeah, that's what I want.
Alright, so here's the thing. The earth is obviously round, alright?
I don't know about that.
No, it is. There's science that backs that up. What I do think is interesting is the phenomenon of a technological innovation where the distance between individuals, societies, nation states, continents, whatever, essentially becomes flat or becomes deleted so that every experience is photographed right on your phone. Boom, boom, boom. We can talk to each other in an instant right here or countries away. And basically, because we get to see things we've never seen before.